Master Lozier, good evening, sir.
Yeah, welcome. How you doing?
I did fine. I did fine, Master Lozier. Good evening, dear friends and lovers of freedom. Master Lozier, I hope I'm coming out very clear, right?
We did hear you properly.
Okay. Good evening, dear friends and friends of dear friends and lovers of freedom. My name is Mazi Chinasa Nworu. Mazi Chinasa Nworu is serving the indigenous people of Biafra in the Directorate of State. I'm coming this evening just to make this short observation and clarification on air. Mazi Lozie, why I am on air, this emergency calling now is because of, for a couple of days now, there are a lot of people have started again. When it seems we have kept things to keep the family going the way it's supposed to go, but some people are now trying to take this way we want to handle this thing to put their hands into our eyes, and that is not going to happen. I'm coming on air right now to make a clarification of those who are using the name of ESN and IPOB to raise fund that does not come to IPOB or goes to ESN. That is why I come on air. There is a flyer moving around, a Zoom meeting that they are going to. The person who is going to host this thing is Rabbi Mrs. Bridget and the Madam Oyibo. These are the people, their name, they say this Zoom meeting is on October 17th. This particular fundraising is not approved by the IPOB Directorate of State. We are not aware of this fundraising, and I am using this opportunity this time because we have tried to be gentle in all these things we are doing. We have tried to respect people, but they don't want to respect themselves. You cannot be using the name of ESN and IPOB to raise money, and we don't know where the money is going. Those who are clamoring to raise this money, what do they know about ESN? What do they know about ESN? Today, they are jumping around from one place to another in the name of ESN, trying to raise money in the name of ESN. And when they raise this money, they become tinkle. Most of them using the name of ESN to raise money and IPOB, and if it is not approved by the Directorate of State, this will be the last time this nonsense will happen. Because they raise this money, they refuse to release money for the men on ground. And I can say it on this radio, these particular people holding the money for ESN since 23rd of August, they have refused to release $1 for the taking care of the men on ground from 23rd of August. Instead, when we try to raise this topic, they start to blackmail somebody. They start to blackmail somebody's name. Since 23rd of August, today is 14th of October, they have seized every money to take care of the men on ground. And they will turn around and say it is Chinasa Nworu that is responsible, that is holding the money of IPOB or ESN. Those who are in IPOB knows me. I don't do anything with their finance. I don't know where their finance goes. And this is the last time we are going to take this nonsense. Whoever is using the name of ESN, trying to raise money that the Directorate of State is not aware, from now onwards, we are not going to take it lightly. Because this nonsense is too much. When ESN was formed, they don't know. ESN is formed now, they are running around. When Ikonso died, when they massacred Ikonso, they raised money in the name of Ikonso. Ask them, where is that money in the name of Ikonso? These same people that are using the name of ESN today, raising money. Ask them, when Ikonso died, they made the same raising of fund in the name of Ikonso, may his soul rest in peace. Ask them, have they given $1 to that family? To today, Izombe, something has happened in Izombe. They want to use it to raise money also. When they raise it, you don't know where they are giving the money. And they will turn around to blackmail other people in the Directorate of State. I am making it very clear. This is the last time we are going to say this warning. This is the last time I, Magistrate Sawori, will say this thing on air. I do not care whatever anybody thinks. This nonsense is too much. This nonsense is too much from some of these women. When you talk, they say you don't have respect for women. They continue to blackmail somebody's name. They will go in the back. They will tell them, Tina Sawori is holding the money for IPOB. But they are the one holding the money. Then we said, why I do not know where the single sales, single dollar of IPOB money is. I always request for money to take care of the problem happening at home. They will be holding the money and they will be talking rubbish. Every day they continue to use the name of ESN and IPOB to raise money. What nonsense is this? What nonsense is this? And I'm not going to take it. I am going to take this issue to wherever these vultures and hyenas that are in IPOB, that came into IPOB to come to destroy IPOB. Some of them have finished their trading, online trading stock. They have duped people the way they like. Now they have dropped to IPOB, ESN, to raise money. Some of them have duped people on immigration. I will send you to Canada. I will send you on this. They have finished that one. They have come into IPOB. Raise money with IPOB. Everybody will jump up from everywhere he is and come here to destroy the name of IPOB and ESN. You are holding the money of IPOB. You are holding the money of ESN. When they request from you, you don't do anything. You have spiritual attack. Is it my problem? Is it the problem of ESN? Why you will not send them money? If there is no money, you tell their friends there is no money. You are holding the IPOB money and using it as a ransom. This nonsense has to stop. And that is why I came on air this evening, Major Lozier. There is no fundraising on the name of ESN on 17th October. Whoever is posting that thing they want, they will get it. In the name of ESN, that thing they want, they will get it. Tonda, Chino, Amadio, Mafkwahishi, Ndiwoshi. Major Lozier, sorry for my voice to be very high, but I'm very, very upset this evening because of the nonsense. These women and some of them who are using the name of ESN to make money and make caricature of what we are doing. And I am ready for them. I am ready for them. Whatever they want this time, they will get it. They want to destroy what Mazin Nnamdi Kanu spent time and years to build. They don't know. Some of them have never come near IPOB. When the volunteers were raised, some of them have never think of IPOB. When these men were raised as volunteers, today now they come out using their name to make money and sit down and talk rubbish. And it's not going to happen. I mean, it's not going to happen. If they want to try, let them try. Let them try. Maza Lozier, any fundraising that is not approved by the Maza Lozier in the GOS will never be announced on this radio. Can never be announced on this radio. What nonsense is this? They're nonsense over here. What nonsense is this? Every day they're insulting the DOS because we try to play gentle. Only of you see. The other time here, one of the members of DOS, one of the women, who has dubbed everything said in the DOS and sent it to this moles. We said anything in the DOS, they pick it up and send to their moles. Countering everything we are doing. And the moment the woman was removed, you see them coming out in all their different colors. Mazolozie, I'm very sorry for the way I have raised my voice on this radio, but to show you how angry I am, because we continue to keep silent. Machachineke, this is not about anything. This is the Biafra struggle. Anybody play with the life of our people is not talking on Facebook. This is not Facebook talk. This is not online talk. If you play with the life of our people, I will keep everything on the table for them. I told them, I am intentionally keeping silent. I am intentionally keeping silent. If anybody play with the life of our people, you play with the life of our people, the life of people on the ground, the life of our members. They give you account to send somebody money, you use it. How many of our people are in the prison in Abuja? Because you send them money. These are Moles. These are Nigerian agents. You give them account to send money to help somebody at home. They use it and hand over to federal government. Many of our people have been cashed in the bank and executed. Many are in Abuja. And we are still talking about these people because you have an opportunity to send money for our people at home. And they come here, do they know how many of our people have been killed from the accounts they gave to them? Do they know how many of our people are in abattoir in Abuja because of accounts given to them to send money to the people? And they are coming out here to talk nonsense. Let them make nonsense again. I will present all these names. I will present it to the public, all the people that they have sent money to, and they are in abattoir in Abuja. Let them make this nonsense again. I don't want your hands. You think it's coming on Facebook, coming to dance? If I want to reach again, put again, I call it. Mazalozie, I'm very sorry for raising my voice, but I'm very upset this evening. I'm very, very upset this evening of what is happening. And people are looking at these stupid fellows, these vultures and hyenas. Looking at them, I am out for them. Once again, dear friends, my name is Mazichina Sanworu. I am very, very emotional. I'm very upset this evening because of the nonsense going out there, always coming out from some group of moles. Who knows what happened to our leader? But our leader will come out and use his mouth and say it. What happened to them? Those of them who betrayed the leader. Those of them who have planned all these things. We know them. Every day, things are opening. We are trying to understand, and we're beginning to understand most of them in America who participated in the selling of our leader.
Mazi.
And they run around and start blaming people. Run around and start accusing innocent people.
Mazi Chinasa.
They are going to hear from us.
Yes.
They're going to hear from us.
I thought that DOS has given a final directive with regard to the raising of money. Where is this coming from?
Mazi Alozie.
Chinasa, calm down. Chinasa.
Yes.
Chinasa.
I'm down.
Calm down.
I'm down.
Yes.
Mazi Alozie, the DOS gave approval of fundraising on 16th. This fundraising is pertaining to Bruce Fein, the lawyer. Are you understanding me?
Yes.
The lawyer handling the case for our leader. The fundraising is specifically for Bruce Fein issue. You can confirm this from Mrs. Bridget. Now, because they found out that a fundraising has been set up for Bruce Fein issue on 16th, they connively put 17th. Say it's ESM fund. From information we have, they're trying to persuade the people organizing the Bruce Fein fundraising to forget that one and do this one. Are you understanding me? And do this one. They've made their flyer. They start. But let me ask people, is it Rabbi Charles that everybody know what Rabbi Charles is doing? So Rabbi Charles is now the person coming to host, to raise fund. Rabbi Charles, you have been making audio, calling people all sorts of names that we don't even know where he gets all these things, abusing and accusing everybody. He's the one now going to host fundraising for ESN. Many of them have caused a lot of problem at home. Against the directives guiding the ESN operatives. Most of them, I think you saw a video circulating around. People committing crimes in the name of ESN. ESN have their structure, IPOB have their structure. They have the mechanism how they monitor everything they do. But people out of greed, what they want, I do not understand. There is no connection between the fundraising of Bruce Fein and the fundraising of ESN. Besides, most of the money you see they are raising these days making on behalf of ESN, We don't know where they go to. They can kill that account. We have to stop here until our leader comes out. If our leader comes out and tell them continue to do the fundraising, that's fine and good. But for now, they have refused to bring out any money since 23rd of August. Since 23rd of August. That was the last time the authorized person refused to bring money. When we talk about this, he start blackmail. They start blackmailing everywhere. They start blackmailing Shida Sanwo-Olu. Because I told them, before that, the same woman has threatened me. If we don't do something against Nnennaya, he will stop the money coming. At the early stage, I neglected her. For 6-7 days, I refused to talk to her because she said if we don't do something about Nnennaya, that she's going to stop the fund flowing. I, out of anger, for 6-7 days, I refused to talk to her. I come back again. I tell her, please, my dealings with you is to provide the fund for things that are being done. But if you don't want to provide it, you can also make it very clear to me you are not going to provide. But not you go in the back and tell people that you are now in charge of ESN, that you tell this person you send them money. Where is the money? Who did you send it to? Mazalozi, I'm making this clarification today for people to understand. Before Shida Sanwo-Olu, we get mad on them. And people will come to yap their mouth, which I do not give a fucking damn. We are in freedom fighting. Our people are dying on a daily basis. We do not come here to gossip. We do not come here to joke. We can talk on Facebook, but when you meet us on ground or in business, we are a different animal. We are fighting for survival, for Christ's sake. These people are playing with the intelligence of our people. They come here to gossip and look for who they will call, talk and say anything. That is not why we are here. They should respect themselves. This is IPOD. This is not any group. We are different from anything you have seen. They are dragging running around. Where were they? Mazin Nnamdi Kanu did not give them the leadership. It is when Mazin Nnamdi Kanu leave, all of them come out and start dragging everywhere. Mazalozie, this is the four things these people were sent to destroy in IPOD. Let me make it very clear, let their friends hear. We know everything they come for. There are four particular things they were sent to destroy in IPOD. Number one, to destroy the finance of IPOD. That is the number one thing they said. That's why when they came, they fought tooth and nail to make sure they destroy the German account so that every money will be coming to them in America. And they will do that thing they are doing now. That was the first thing. That was why immediately our leader was arrested 5 days. Even I don't think if it's up to 5 days, they started their onslaught on the account in Germany. They started their onslaught. We know. We are ahead of them. Another thing they want to take over is the radio. The IPOB radio, the radio Biafra. That is why you see them, they fought tooth and nail. Go to the American women. If you go to them today, they will remind you why you didn't hand over the radio to this person. Till today, it is one of their grudges. It is one of their grudges. That is number two, they want to take over the radio. Number three, they were asked to destroy the IPOB leadership, the DOS. Because people who gave them information gave them that the moment they arrest Mazin Nnamdi Kanu, that the remaining people is the Directorate of State, if they can manage to destroy them, make them, for Biafrans to lose confidence in them, destroy the leadership, and that is the end of it. And the fourth one is the ESN. The fourth thing they were asked to destroy is the ESN. They asked them to stack the fund, seize the fund, let them beg, then you control them. But as long as me, Shida Sanwo-Olu, is alive, and in the absence of Mazin Nnamdi Kanu, with my fellow members in the DOS, headed by Maizi Chike Dozie, They can never do more than a dead rat. IPOB, we have 1,000 lives. You stop us here, we move to the next level. You stop us here, we move to the next level. Since 23rd of August, they seized the fund. They refused to release fund. Our men, are they dying? Have our men died? No, they won't die. They won't die. They seized the fund thinking we will come on our knees to beg them because they have threatened me that if I don't do what they want, they will never release money. And later, they later did it. Today, our men dying. Before they come, IPOB was. Mazaloze, this is the things I want to clear. So every Biafran, open your mind. Understand where they are going. Their proxies, all they are using. Open your mind. These are the four things they were asked to destroy in IPOB. Destroy the finance. Destroy the radio Biafra. Destroy IPOB leadership and destroy ESN. Start them fund so that the men will go outside and start looking for something to eat. This is the nonsense we are getting from few women in America. When I talk, they say I don't have respect for womanhood. But it is the behavior some of them are bringing to this struggle. The behavior they are bringing to this struggle. This is Hannah from Wokakanisi in America. If they don't know. Thank you, Mazaloziye, dear friends.